Welcome back to the Shtick. I'm here with Keith Lawrence to talk about the Israeli Film Festival.
We are indeed.
And absolutely. What's your shtick, Keith?
My shtick? Well, as you'll have just seen in the trailers, it's been very much... My shtick is actually to put that programme together for the festival, ninth festival, Israeli Film Festival, taking place here in Australia. Unusually this year, what's really good news for everyone, not just us, is the fact that in the past it's always been just Melbourne and Sydney over 5 days each. Mm-hmm. This year we've actually been able to expand it right out to basically include Brisbane, Adelaide and Perth. So it really is a national festival, giving Australian audiences the opportunities to see a lot more of Israeli films. So it's great.
It's currently been running in Sydney, and when we go to air, it'll start a couple of days after we go to air in Melbourne for 2 whole weeks.
Yeah, well, that's the exciting thing about it. And it's because we've really invested time, energy, effort into expanding the festival, there's 20 films. It's going in Melbourne and Sydney, it's going over 14 days, whereas in the past it's only been 5 days and about 7 or 8 films. So it's increased exponentially from previous years. And so it's plenty of opportunities to see such a diverse programme of films.
And there's also the fact that there are so many accolades now for Israeli films and so much more recognition than there ever was.
Absolutely. I mean, people have been asking me why an Israeli film festival, and I think originally the idea was that when we first launched it as the ACE Israeli Film Festival, the Australia-Israel Cultural Exchange, it was very much about ACE promoting cultural exchange, like its name suggests, between the two countries. And so it was, the motivations were political, but with a small p.
Yeah.
You know, that concept of basically saying, you know, Israel's not just about conflict, it's not just about military, it's not just about politics. It's much more everyday issues are going on. So the film festival's very much about exactly that sort of thing. It's about diverse subject matter, basically, that essentially concerns your everyday Israeli.
Like, for example, the opening night film, Restoration.
Restoration, indeed. It's about fatherhood. It's about the title Restoration is about Yaakov, who's an aging antique restorer.
Yeah.
In a craftsmanship that's not in so much demand these days.
No.
So it's an alien business. But it's also a metaphor for the need to restore his relationship with his son and his son's need to restore his relationship with his pregnant wife. So it's a family drama set within, a sort of old, slightly old-fashioned environment, which is, Sundance scriptwriting.
Thank you. I know that.
I'm glad to hear it. I forgot it for a second. So, and it also won. It's won several awards in several film festivals around the world. So it's the perfect opening film, basically.
And Israeli films have also been nominated for Best Foreign Film in the last 5 years, or 4 out of the last 5.
The Israeli film has become so in demand, so good. It's just won about everything. In the last 10 years, it's just won about everything it possibly could win as far as the awards, other than, sadly, the Oscar.
Oh, well, it's elusive for a lot of people. Israel's not the only one. People
absolutely.
Have been trying for years and years to get an Oscar.
Absolutely.
It's very difficult to find. But ACE, I'd like to just talk about for a moment, is trying to foster understanding and cohesion between Israel and Australia.
Absolutely.
And there's a corresponding film festival in Israel that shows Australian films.
That's right. Well, that also has been going exactly the same time as the Israeli Film Festival here.
Which I think is a fantastic idea.
Yeah, well, but also the beauty of it is that it develops a relationship between individuals within the film industry. So it's not just about screening films and bringing audiences along to see the films.
Yeah.
But Australian and Israeli filmmakers are always talking together. Screen Australia and the Israeli equivalent, the Israel Film Fund, are constantly talking. Because what's interesting for the Australians is that in Israel, for a industry that's of a similar size in terms of number of feature films it produces, Israel commands somewhere between 12 and 15% of its audience for its home films, whereas here in Australia, it's sadly only about 4%.
Really?
And so Australians are just basically saying, how do you do it? Mm. You know, they're talking to the Israelis and saying, how do you do it? Show us.
There's one way to learn, and that's to work together.
That's the point of the film festival. So we've got Evgenia Dadina, who's a major film star in Israel,
and also theatre.
And she's coming here for the 1 week in Melbourne. And she will be meeting not only, you know, key people in the Jewish community, but also key people in the film industry. Mm. So that
and I'm interviewing her.
And you're interviewing her?
Yeah,
well, there you go. It's all about sustainable, you know, developing sustainable relationships.
Well, that's fantastic. Well, it's been great for you to come along and
thank you for having me.
Talk to our audience about that. And we're going out with a lady called Jacqueline Felice, who is an Elvis tribute artist. And she's been on the Shtick before many years ago, and she's currently in Graceland, where approximately 70,000 people came for the 35th Yahrzeit, or anniversary of Elvis's. It's amazing. 1977. It just happened yesterday.
Years. 35 years, it can't be possible.
So we're going out with the edge of reality from She Is the King, and we'll see you next week for season 30 of the Shtick starting this spring. See you then. Shalom. And thank you again, Keith.
Thank you.
Great to see you.
Okay.
Good luck with the film festival.
Thank you.
And make sure you get there.
If he's not real, then I am condemned to the edge of reality. On the edge of reality, where he overpowers me with fears that I can't explain. He drove me to the point of madness.